Just a moment ago, we mentioned Little's Law. Little's Law is a formula that helps us calculate the minimum possible level of work in progress given the throughput rate, the quantity of stuff done per time period, and the throughput time, or the wait time, by which I mean the time it takes for something to go through our manufacturing system, be that products or services, of course. We said that the formula L equals lambda W stands for L, the level of work in progress, the quantity of inventory, multiplied by lambda, which is the throughput rate, the quantity of stuff we are making per time period, multiplied by W, the throughput time. So, question time. Get your pen and paper. We've got a little maths question if you want to play. My factory makes 1,000 widgets per day, and we have a throughput time of 5 days. What is the minimum quantity of work in progress we must have right now in order to be functioning? Okay, did you want to work along? Pause the video now if you want to do the equation yourself. Okay, did you get it? Let's find out. L equals lambda W. L, the level of work in progress, equals lambda, the throughput rate, that's our 1,000 items per day, multiplied by our throughput time. That, in our case, was 5 days. 1,000 per day times 5 days equals 5,000. There is a minimum, there must be a minimum of 5,000 widgets in our system at any one time for this system to be working. That doesn't necessarily mean it's good. If I'm the boss's boss of this factory and I think that this level of inventory is excessive, it could be improved, but it would mean that we have to do one of two things. Either we have to reduce the amount of stuff we make per day, that's probably not a popular option, or we have to reduce the time it takes to get through our system. Does it need to spend 5 days from start to finish? How could we get it down to 3 days from start to finish? Probably most of the time inside our factory is actually waiting to start the various sub-processes. But now we're digressing somewhat. Let's do a second example with Little's Law, because this formula is really powerful. Now this time you're going to have to rearrange the formula just a little bit. So here we go. I have a telephone call centre, and on average we have about 500 customers we're working with at any one moment in time. These are our work in progress. Now we can process about 1,000 customers per hour. I want to know, what is the average time a customer spends inside our process, including their waiting time and the time we deal with them? Pause the video now, rearrange that formula, and see if you can get the answer yourself. Okay, did we do it? To do this, we first have to rearrange our formula. W equals L divided by lambda. W, our time, is what we want to find out. L is our level of work in progress, or in our case, the 500 customers we have on average in our system at any moment in time. And lambda is the throughput rate, the rate we're able to process them, which we said is 1,000 per hour. W equals L over lambda. W equals 500 over 1,000. W equals half an hour. So what does this tell us? Well, let's imagine in this situation, what we'd really like to do is reduce the throughput time of our average customer. Remember, this time includes, in this example, the waiting time on the telephone line to be answered and the time actually spent talking to them. Well, there's two things this formula says we can do. The first, reduce L, the level of work in progress we have in our system. We could just disconnect half of the people on the lines. That would immediately half the average time that the people in our system spend. Secondly, we would have to increase lambda, increase our throughput rate, our ability to deal with the orders. So, Little's Law, an incredibly versatile formula that lets us work out the level of work in progress inventory given the throughput rate and the lead time.